would like to just tell you a few words about is on the meeting between our two presidents, between President Marcos Jr. and President Macron. This encounter was it's really very much part of our vision of the Indo-Pacific and our strategy in the Indo-Pacific. This is an area where we are part and parcel. We are part of the Indo-Pacific. We are neighbor countries to the Philippines, and our priorities in the Indo-Pacific completely fit with the priorities of this government. So the themes I thought that their photo was still behind me, but it's no longer is. There was a long phone conversation between our two presidents, and then they met again in person in New York in the margins of the General Assembly. One of the topics they discussed is, of course, everything that is linked to a rules-based multipolar order, and particularly the UN Convention on the Law of the Seas. France has seen, as you know, its military deployment increase in the region, our commitment also to cooperation and deepening the cooperation with the Philippines in the areas of defense, security, maritime drills, port calls, the modernization of maritime capabilities. You remember that Rear Admiral Ray, when he came, had a sentence I like. He said, at sea, all the things that are not secured are looted or polluted. And I think that's a very good definition of what happens. So protecting sovereignty as well as natural resources is very important. And of course, this was one of the discussions, including, of course, the modernization of the Navy and including the discussions around a submarine offer. So this is really one of the priority areas that were discussed. Other priorities that were discussed are also very much linked with the international situation at the moment. As you know, we've been through two major crises over the last few years, major disruptions, the pandemic, of course, that has really disrupted our world, our travel, our economies, and now the unprovoked invasion of Ukraine by Russia, which has also been disrupting our food supply, our fuel supply, and information, by the way, because this conflict is what we can call perhaps the first hybrid conflict that is taking place in a Europe that thought that war was behind us, that for the last 70 years we lived in peace, and all of a sudden there it comes, and it's very much a hybrid war because it takes place, of course, on the ground, but it also takes place through information, disinformation, and also through food and fuel, energy being weaponized. So the two other areas that were discussed is around energy security and for the Philippines to develop decarbonized energy sources and to go towards a green energy. And so there are many opportunities that can be bringing our countries together. We work a lot in France on wind energy, solar energy, of course, there's geothermal, hydroelectricity, hydrogen power plant, and there is one that's being developed in Zamboanga City at the moment, and of course nuclear. And nuclear wouldn't be at all the old kind of nuclear power plants. We have many of them in France because they were built 40 or 45 years or more ago, but we're moving now towards a new technology, which is the smart nuclear reactors. And this is something that is very much adapted to the geography of the Philippines in the sense that you can have modular, smaller units that can be on islands and you don't need to have a huge grid or to have a huge production somewhere. So this is an area where we are going to work more closely, and we would probably have soon a mission of experts from France coming to discuss with your experts here. The second is, of course, food security. And this is also a very, very high stage. As the Philippines needs to import quite a lot of its food. The prices for fuel and for food are going up, so it's a burden also on the state. And this is one area where we're also going to work on in areas of agriculture, also green development, sustainable and inclusive agriculture. And that would be one of our key priorities between the two governments. As you know, on an international basis, our President Macron, has been very much involved in developing an international initiative called the Farm Initiative, which is meant to be based on the COVAX model, that is, it would help provide access to affordable quality food for vulnerable population, as COVAX was focusing on vaccines. So this is also an area. And finally, of course, everything related to climate and biodiversity, with a particular focus on the oceans. As you know, France organized the One Ocean Summit in February last year, in the framework of our French presidency of the European Union. And we're also proposing to host the next UN conference on the oceans with the Costa Rica in 2025. So this is going to be another area of focus and support. This is an area where there is a lot to do, and a lot we can do better together also in protecting biodiversity, protecting climate change, and also working politically together to build consensus on the importance of safeguarding fragile marine ecosystems to move forward to take concrete steps. And we know that your country is very much a victim of climate change issues, as we see with typhoons coming, and that means also coastal erosion, that means also destructions of goods and of course lives. And this is really a very, very important issue. The protection of ecosystems is a crucial part, of course, of climate resilience. And we will continue to support you, as well, Senator will talk about it, since we're talking about the needs, but our colleagues from the ADB and the French Agency of Development, so Bénédicte Gazon from the French Agency of Development and Anne Marchat from ADB will be talking to you about it. So to conclude, not to be too long, let me tell you again how happy I am that we are here together. This is, we've repeated it so often, you must be really fed up with it, but this is the celebration of our 75th anniversary. Again, there's a lot we've done together, there's much more we can do together. We have many, many more events lined up for this year. I won't talk about it because we're going to have a specific press conference on that on October 18th, as many, many things are going to happen on the second half of October till the end of the year. But I think that this is a testament to our long-term relationship. It started much before even the date when we signed the Treaty of Amity in 1947. And as I always say, let's look at the next 75 years. There's a lot we have to do, and the Senator is certainly going to tell us more about what we can do together in climate change and biodiversity protection issues.
You mentioned earlier in your talk there about experts on energy security expecting to come here. They have that right?
Yes, we are working on task forces on food security on the one hand and on energy security on the other hand. So the teams in Paris are beginning to meet and together to look at how we can work together on those two topics. And yes, we will have our task forces representatives coming over to the Philippines in the near future. I cannot say when exactly, but when our two presidents met, President Macron said they will come soon and quickly. That's what he said.
Mostly all French, or is the Filipinos also included in the task force?
Well, at the moment we are gathering the right people in France, and then the purpose is to come over and to work with the Filipino and to see, to listen, to hear what the needs are, to see where the exchange of best practices can take place and what can we do together. But we are really at a very early stage.
Thank you so much
Thank
for
you.
Your time.
Thank you.